So before commencing the session, so regarding assignment, students, if you are going to continue the same type of fashion that being followed for the same exam pattern for Anna University, in that case, your assignments will be given more weightage. So submit your assignments like your seniors. You are going to write your MCQs for university examination means your weightage will be more on your submissions only, right? Based upon your three assignments plus the two assignments that what you are going to submit. Cumulatively, you have five assignments. Five assignments will have the equal weightage. Along with that, the MCQs that what you are appearing for your weekly test, these will combine you, will give the score for 70, right? So kindly remember, don't forget to submit your assignments. Don't make us to track and follow. Apart from this, we have a lot of other responsibilities too. So kindly complete it. Even I know that the people are very busy in placements. I think you can spend for half an hour, right? So it's not a matter that you could be able to complete it and close it. That will not be a big and tedious job. Even the assignments that what we are giving, which will be useful for your campus related purpose only. We are not giving anything out of scope. So kindly do this. Don't make us to follow. Right? So that could be the preliminary section that I want to roll it up here for all the three sections. So in the last session we discussed on completely about the inception of software engineering part pertaining to SOA. SOA is a design approach actually. Right? So we have seen delivery strategies. Pertaining to textbook, we have seen three delivery strategies, but pertaining to research papers which are available, that we have four delivery strategies. So what type of strategy that I need to follow, that I have to choose depending upon my framework, that what I am going to design, right? So that could be the major idea. If I am going to design a complete application for a networked hospitals, right, a multi-speciality networked hospitals, so in that case, what would be the strategy that I have to follow, right? That could be a case. Okay, so if I'm going to design a personal management system for a student administration in a college or in a group of campus, so in that case, what is the strategy that I have to follow? That I have to design based upon the complex parameters that are involved in this, right? So that could be the major case. Probably in OOAD, you won't do this actually. In OOAD, after your requirements gathering analysis, then you are going to ready to represent these things in times of seven types of diagrams, that you will ready to represent those functional requirements. Okay, so that could be the case. But here, apart from the functional requirements, how these functional requirements are interlinked, how these functional requirements are being carried out in heterogeneous locations, right? So how these are functional requirements are being called by a third party requirement. So all those things also you have to consider. Here also you will see some different types of diagrams that what you have come across in your OOAD, right? But be clear with the students, before SOE is ready to give its modeling technique, even in SOA, OOAD diagrams only followed. If you take the old contents from 2003 to 2010, during the period, if you come across the old documents in the web, you could able to see wherever if you are ready to take the documents for service-oriented architecture pertaining to design and modeling, you could see class diagram, your component diagram, right, interaction diagram, activity diagram. Only these diagrams only you could able to come across, right? Because the modeling was not being restricted only to SOE environment on those days. Because even though we are migrated from object-oriented architecture to service-oriented architecture, still we are following the conventions of OOAD. Right? To overcome that only, they have designed this. Because in OOAD, functional requirements are being represented very clearly in terms of label in class diagram, right? Might be, I think you could be able to remember the class diagram. Within a rectangle that you will mention the, what are all the variables that you have used, as well as what are all the methods that you are going to use. So methods will convey the corresponding label, and variables will convey as the actual convention of the data that what I'm going to use, right? So that could be the major criteria. So the flow can be identified through my sequence diagram. So by that I could be able to conclude for OOAD, but here it doesn't like that. Okay, even how your functional requirements are going to be communicated in the layers of SOA, because in OOAD we don't have any layers, right? Direct functional requirements are being accessed through my corresponding blueprint for the objects, right? So in the in those cases that could be a complete one. Recently I have come across a complete SOA architecture being designed, was could be exhibited very easily. Even students, you can try on that cloud.ibm.com. so if you visit this website, you could able to create your own cloud space, and you could able to access all the services related to for example, if you are ready to concentrate with the artificial intelligence, you have set of services are available. For deep learning, you have set of services are available. For machine learning, you have set of services are available. Combining all those things, for cognitive science, you have set of services are available. So those services are being available as a creamy layer, right? Once you select the type of service, what are all the internal services I could be able to use? For example, I am going to use my visual recognition service, right? Nothing but image classification, object detection, etc., etc. Otherwise, speech recognition service, TTS or STTT, right? So what I'm going to do? So if I'm going to choose this service, for all these technologies, artificial AI, ML, DL, they have only the base service as a common one, right? If I'm going to access via my AI platform, I'm going to access the same service. But once it is going to be converted into a blueprint, the blueprint will be something different pertaining to my AI. The fundamentals of AI started with my CSPs and other things. Okay, so those types of constraints will be available in the AI platform. If I am ready to travel through my machine learning, so what will happen? Once if I load my data set, by default it is ready to convey me the type of data set what I have loaded, and what are all the impurities present in the data set. After cleaning the impurities, the available set of algorithms are being automatically launched, and what would be the accuracy if I'm going to train the algorithm using this data, everything that I could able to receive. See, the idea here is not about learning technology, how the services are being communicated with each other in the heterogeneous environment, right? Even if I'm going to change the platform, how is their nature of exhibitancy? So that can be modeled through this type of environment only, right? So that's what we are going to see here, right? So you could have a try on this cloud.ibm.com. Kindly use our college email to get into this, right? So that will help you a lot. You have a lot of resources also there. So people want to ramp through their final year project through AI or ML or DL. So especially students who felt tough to code, that you can choose this environment. That will be easy for you. Even students who are familiar with the code, if you don't want to write much code on this case, services are available. Just you could be able to take the API and you could be able to use it. When we are coming for object-oriented environment, you don't have this provision, right? So everything will be available as a method only. That method will be accessed through object. But the place where API calls are being completely accessed, nothing but, for example, I have designed an image classifier for brain tumor, right? For brain tumor, I have designed an image classifier. So if I'm going to load the corresponding X-ray or scan, by that it will convey me the if the tumor is available or not, present or not, or if the tumor is available, what could be the percentage or significance of the tumor in the corresponding part. It is ready to retrieve the type of accuracy, right? So in that case, if I want to call this classifier, no need to call the entire code, right? In object-oriented environment, this will be called, for example, void method classifier. This could be the this could be the function name. So if I want to use this classifier, what I will do, I will use obj dot method classifier. So within that argument, I will pass my method name. I will pass my x-ray or scan image, right? This could be the way that I will access. But pertaining to here in SOA, what will happen? If I want to use this, I will pass this one as a parameter. Okay, I will get a classifier ID. When you are going to run in your service, the service will give you a classifier ID. That ID will be a caption name, or it could be something called a key, right? So if you want to use your Google Map, customized Google Map, you will get a 32-bit key, right? So likewise, you will get a key for this. Using the key that you could able to key or ID that you could able to substitute in the place where you want to call, right? So completely lightweight when you are going to use this service-oriented architecture, right? So in those cases, how these communications will happen, right? We don't have any layers in OAD, right? But here in SOAD, we have the basic layers, what we have seen in our SOA, right? So the same layers will be followed, right? So that could be the major thing. By this introduction, let us commence today's session. Right? I think you have come across these terms, architecture, analysis, right? Again, the modeling, computing, programming, right? All those things are being a derived one, actually. Okay. So architecture part we have seen, analysis and design, modeling that we are going to see, service-oriented computing, service-oriented programming. These two things that you are learning in cloud computing as well as in SOA. In SOA, we are teaching you web service. Web service is nothing but a service-oriented programming. So when you are coming for your cloud computing, allocation of resources will come under this service-oriented computing, right? So this could be the a variation that what you have seen as principles in your second unit. Okay. So service-oriented modeling. I don't want to differentiate analysis, design, right? Analysis and design and the modeling. I want to take this part as a whole. That is the reason why I have combined all these three topics. If you come across your syllabus, first they will talk about analysis, next week talk about design, then they go for modeling. But for modeling, the basic things are analysis and design only. So that could be the thing. So when we go for modeling, because pertaining to modeling in OOAD, requirements gathering, after that you will have the feasibility study report. Using the feasibility study report, you will filter out the functional requirements and non-functional requirements. So functional requirements could be directly taken as a analysis report, right? SRS report. So ultimately what will happen, that can be transformed into design. But here we need to do these things in a parallel fashion. I think you might remember the flow diagram that what we have seen, the delivery strategy, when you are coming for your top down or bottom up or the middle in the out, as well as the third, fourth strategy, that middle in the in. So all these four types of SOA delivery strategies, we'll talk about this actually, right? So modeling consists of both this analysis and design only. So that is the reason why instead of doing modeling manually, OOAD will have that the open source UML, right? So through that UML, they have designed this. But for SOA, what is the software that we will have? So we are having that BPMN, right? Business Process Modeling Notation. That could be a plugin available with our BPEL. So using that, you could be able to do. Otherwise, most of the companies, most of the corporates have released their own modeling platforms, right? So that's also available, accessible at for trial versions are available, right? Even some of the major universities in foreign countries, especially in Middle East, they have designed their own SOAD tool for their laboratory purposes, right? So you can design your application, and you could be able to take a snap of the corresponding application. Through that, the requirements can be designed, right? So that could be the major case. And one more thing, here analysis part and design part also can be framed as a service. That's also an interesting thing that you could be able to do. So next time when you are going to do such type of project, no need to go for the all the phases. Just to transform those functional requirements, if already analysis part is available, it is ready to reuse it, right? If it is on the same thing. For example, for network of hospitals, you have designed the framework. you are going to create again network of some multi specialty stores, right? So multi specialty stores, a chain set of stores like Big Bazaar. So in that case, most of the contents will be common except the data that what you are going to pass, right? If I'm going, for inventory, if I'm going for stock management, if I'm going for staff management, human resource management. So these particulars, only the corresponding data will get to vary, but not the skeleton part. So in those cases, it will ready to give us the idea. That's what they are termed as assets. Okay. So once it is created, everyone could be able to reuse it. So that could be the idea. I think IBM have given you the platform actually, SOMA, right? So service oriented modeling and architecture, right? So for that they have given those corresponding tool also available in IBM. That's the reason why I'll be searching you in cloud.ibm.com. You have this tool also, so you could be able to use this tool. You can use this tool. I think you have a restriction of around 250 MB to use that tool, right? Because the images generated by the corresponding tool will have the weightage. That's the reason. So once you have generated, just download the corresponding design part, and you could be able to erase that service, or you could be able to uninstall the service, right? So that will be more useful, and you could be able to use it throughout the year. So that's the reason why I'll be suggesting you, right? So ultimately, what could be the flow when I'm going to compare my object-oriented analysis and design? So that's what the people will be representing here in terms of three phases: identification, specification, and realization. Okay, implement, deploy, manage. Directly, they will coincide with the life cycle, right? So delivery life cycle, they will coincide with this: identification, specification, realization. Identification, specification, already we have come across in software engineering part. Realization, this is an important phase in the service oriented modeling section. Realization, right? Realization means how my functional requirement was practically implemented in the environment, right? Practically utilized in the environment. I have designed here the content for such a case. Even though if I have come across a testing, etc., and other thing, if an unexpected things are going to happen, how it will behave, right? So that's also the major case when I'm going to use. As well as, see, wear and tear for the mechanical or physical parts of any corresponding machines, right? So the performance will improve. If I'm going to use it regularly, my performance will improve. If I'm going to keep it shut, that it will not improve. Like my car or two-wheeler, that if I'm going to use it regularly, that the performance of the corresponding jet engine available in the things will get to improve. Likewise, in software also, we are ready to realize its efficiency when we are going to give tasks to these services. The services will generate lots and lots of logs. Through that, it will identify and learn its, the process of intelligence will be important here. It will identify and learn its experience, right? So that is what they want to incorporate in this intelligent SOMA, right? So nowadays the SOMA is being equipped with the future of intelligence also. Realization, they have introduced this term in 2004, right? Please remember. So the framework, the platform that what they have come over on, that I think I have given you the two websites over there: modelingconcepts.com, sparksystems.com.au. I think from that you could be able to download this software that can be able to design, right? So some of the features that you cannot able to access, only premium users could be able to access those things. But it's enough for academic purpose. We could be able to design a complete software using that. Even I'll show you the entries also, how they have designed this modeling framework, right? So like UML, you have a framework to design the corresponding requirements also, right? So that's also applicable here, right? I think what is the delivery model that you have to practice? What is the delivery model that you have to choose? So that must be mentioned over there. So that's what the methodology that here they are ready to justice. So what are all the parameters that here we have to take into account? That's the major one that will differentiate your OIAD with my SOAD, right? Number of modeling practices environments, disciplines, and artifacts. Right? These parameters will help me to move for the types of the different layer components, right? Number of modeling practices. So that will take me the corresponding, the different types of parameters that what I'm going to pass, right? Heterogeneous environments, okay? So how it can be worked overall? Because nowadays the design environments are ready to create. For example, if I'm going to create the front-end design, how this front-end design will be will be visible in my laptop, will be visible in my tab, will be visible in my mobile. So everything could be able to come in a nutshell. No need to work with a separate design, right? So that's also being projected over on the heterogeneous. That's what environments and disciplines. Artifacts means nothing but either I'm going to use the pre-built model or I'm going to use the customized model. So that could be the major case that they are ready to talk about here. Okay, so on the other thing. Normally, what we will do when we are going to generate the blueprint from OOAD, I think you could be able to remember in UML, after designing all your class diagram, all your functional requirements being designed, what you can do, you could get a blueprint of the code, right? You could be able to get a blueprint of the code. You can choose in which language you need the blueprint. By default, in C++, you will have UML, you have C++. Either you could be able to change it to Java also. So it will generate the code from my design, from my diagrams. It will give me my code, forward engineering, right? So it will ready to generate my code skeletons, right? Code skeletons it will generate. My job is simply to write functions for the corresponding skeleton. That's all. My job will be over. But here, in service-oriented modeling, what I have to provide here is I have to create the service. Here we are not going to work about the complete application environment because we are going to access application as a service itself, right? That's the reason why here completely that we are going to work with the web services. That's what the main thing, how I am going to manage and access the services, right? And also I could be able to define the portfolio of the corresponding service. Portfolio means what are the features that it is ready to receive and accept. Receive and retrieve and it could be able to deliver back, right? So those things also I could be able to customize when I'm going to design for these things, as well as the same type of notations that what we have come across in our OOAD, that's also being available here, right? So to differentiate the relations, right? So starting from the basic relations, that what are the things that you will use in normal DFD, the same way, right? So 1:1, 1:n, m:1, m:n. Right. So likewise, I could be able to design, as well as apart from that, I could have the aggregation, association. So how those types of relationships are being mentioned over there. That's also being being provided over there. Right. Then this could be the complete modeling framework platform that will teach us how to move forward. Right. I think you could be able to see that. See. The complete realization practice, that's the actual environment. Okay, please remember, complete realization architecture. This diagram will give you both modeling, analysis, and design. What is the outcome of this? Right? What is the outcome of this? Outcome is given in the small box that you could be able to see. Solution service, solution architecture. These are all the solutions provided by service-oriented modeling, right? That could be the ultimate content. What are all the things that are supporting to generate this? What are all things? That's what modeling assets. I have a framework. I have a delivery lifecycle roadmap. And I have the disciplines. What could be the types of disciplines for design and architecture? A separate modeling language as well as modeling patterns, right? So through that I could be able to achieve this. Now, in the analysis environment, what are all the disciplines that it is ready to support? That's the first case. Okay, service discovery and analysis discipline, business integration discipline. Service discovery and analysis means how my service will be accessed. Okay, how my service will be accessed. What are all the ways that it can be accessed? For those things also, you have to produce the corresponding design part. That's what they want to suggest here. Business integration, nothing but business logic, the corresponding logic for the every project we have its business logic, right? If I'm going for a bank, credit, debit, right, transfer, likewise, what all the logic will be available, that will be integrated in the corresponding environment. So this could be the outcome for the corresponding analysis environment. Actually, what it would be the case, theory part, that's what my section for conceptual environment, right? What is actually service conceptualization discipline, conceptual architecture discipline. So what type of architecture that I could be able to follow, right? Ultimately this SOA only, in that any specific architecture that I could be able to follow, I could be able to mention that, right? That's what conceptual environment is, completely theoretical. That's what they have given us, abstraction practice, but actual thing where it lies. When I'm coming for design, logical environment, service design discipline, logical architecture discipline, right? So service design, the corresponding framework has been transformed into the real content, right? The real content that will be mentioned over through this service design and logical architecture. Logical architecture might be, you think as your flowchart diagram, right? That it could not be like that. It would be a representation. That representation will be mapped with the corresponding functionalities, right? So that's what they are ready to mention over on the logical environment. So very clearly, conceptual environment is theoretical. Analysis environment is, I am transforming theory into practice. Logical environment is completely practice, right? My BPMN or BPEL or any service-oriented modeling software will ready to work with the logical environment only, right? So those things will provide them the parameter. Those parameters only listed as in the left side as modeling assets, right? If you take any tool for SOMF, these five components will be there: methodology, framework, lifecycle roadmap, discipline for corresponding design architecture, language to be used for modeling, pattern, right? Pattern. I think we have seen a service level interaction pattern. Remember, all those patterns will be available in the modeling patterns, right? So these things will be completely helpful for us to move the case, right? And the thing, what they have added is the additional one, they have given us best practices, right? So what they have given us the best practices. So all those things are your non-functional requirements. That's what. So if I'm going to design a framework using service-oriented modeling, these are all the non-functional requirements they are expecting, right? See, in the non-functional requirements of a product being launched through my waterfall model or a RAD model, that you could be able to see they are given in terms of voice, in terms of objectives as well. So about quality, like, well, they listed you some 5 to 7 parameters as in terms of attributes, like, right? Likewise, the non-functional requirements which are being exhibited, right? And that's the important thing. See, it's very tough for you to feel the non-functional requirements, right? Feel the non-functional requirements that are developed through normal delivery life cycles. But pertaining to SOI delivery life cycle, the best practices are used to make it as feel, right? Virtualization, I could be able to feel it actually. Even though the term is virtual, I could be able to feel it. I am buying a RAM, I am buying a ROM, I am buying an internal space. The framework is being launched. I am ready to access my service and use it. So everything that I could be able to feel and take it forward, that is the powerfulness of service-oriented modeling framework, right? Everything that I could be able to see, I have created a visual recognition service in IBM Watson Studio. I could be able to access this in a Java program by using the classifier ID. Interoperability is completely applicable. Okay, I have created a visual recognition service in IBM Watson Studio. I am accessing it for my what is present in the image, that will be converted into a speech, right? So the image, the data available in the image is converted into speech. Loose coupling, that's also being projected over that. So everything is available as my individual service. That's what the term modularity and componentization. So that's also being available. Business transparency, that could be the major key, because it's the place that will ready to give you. See, when I'm going for billing, right? When I'm going for billing, when I'm ready to access any services, when I'm ready to access any services, I am accessing this service for this many number of times or this much number of MB that it has been consumed, that will be billed for byte by byte. Even in AWS, that you could be able to see this. They will ask you to present your credit card when you are going to open the login. Once it crosses the $3 limit, by default, it will start counting it. How many bytes you have consumed, how many bytes you have consumed, how much storage space you have consumed, how much computational service that you have consumed. For everything byte by byte, they will give you billing. That's what the business transparency is being projected for all types of services that you are ready to access through this, right? So that could be the thing, the one platform which will talk about everything, right? The one platform which will talk about everything, that the major case. And one more thing, students, you can design such type of tool. Even the plug and play effect of these tools could be more nowadays, right? You can design a SOMF tool, right? As a final year project, it's a very easy one, right? Students who are feeling tough to write code, you can think for this project, service oriented modeling framework. If I'm going to give my requirements for the corresponding project, it has to filter the requirements. It has to filter the functional and non-functional requirements. Functional requirements must be analyzed, and it has to generate a feasibility report. After generating the feasibility report, it need to go for analysis and the design. What type of discipline I have to follow, it has to mention. What are all the requirements can be converted into service, but I have to do that. What are all the services that cannot be converted into service, that can be converted into the business logic, that is also being converted. Now two disciplines are being divided. How the discipline, how the service and the logic are going to communicate, those things that you can done through your logical environment. So service design, you can be able to provide that. So finally, it has to give you a diagram like this, right? In terms of specific project, for example, if you are going to launch for a for example, the software to be used in all collector's office for district administration, so what are all the things are necessary? Your tool need to give the clear cut information based upon the corresponding requirements. See, and I'll tell you, in OOAD, the UML will ready to give you only diagrams and codes, right? Diagrams and codes. But in SOAD, it will give you how to access the service. What are all the ways you have the things to access the service? That's the main thing. How can you connect with your corresponding logic with the service? Those things also being retrieved. That's a major case, because we are going to use a basic RPC only, right? XML RPC that can be customized for my SOAP, or that can be customized for my corresponding the second case, RESTful web service, right? So in those cases, how I have to access, right? That's also being to be it's ready to be defined. See, you don't have any code environment till now, right? You don't have any code environment. You can customize. Once requirements are being filtered, you can create the web service for them by analyzing the requirement. For this requirement, whether I have to generate a RESTful web service or I have to generate a corresponding SOAP web service, you can consider that, and you can give the skeleton for the corresponding web service, right? In the skeleton, you can call the method from the business logic, right? Likewise, you could be able to generate output. That's a very good project that you could be able to carry out when you are going to understand and move forward for this service oriented modeling framework. Okay, so that's the thing. By this I will stop here. If you have any clarifications, you can post it in the chat.